8,8 cm Panzerabwehrkanone 43-1L-71 auf Geschützwagen 3-4, Selbstfahrlafette Nashorn, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 164. Hello, you sexy beast, and welcome back to War Thunder. It has been about 6 years now since I've last done a how to pronounce a German tank names video. And I promised you then that I was also going to do a how to pronounce a Russian tank names video. Anyway, we're going to do another one. I have installed a special mod by Infernos1 on live.warfunder.com. I will leave a link in the description of this video where you can download this mod yourself. Because it expands quite heavily on the already quite descriptive names of German vehicles in general. In this video, I will attempt to cover most of the German tank names in the game, with the mod making them even more expensive than they already are. Keep in mind, I won't be able to cover every single one, especially since most of them are repeats and very similar to one another. But I will try to explain what the words mean as we go along. So, if you happen to be in the market for learning German, then this may just be your video. And yes, I will be saying Schweder Panzerspielwagen 7,5 cm Panzerabwehrkanone Sonderkraftfahrzeug 234-4 Panzerabwehrkanonenwagen. This is the leichter Panzerspielwagen Schwere Panzerbüchse 41 Sonderkraftfahrzeug 221. Leichter Panzerspielwagen means light armored scouting vehicle. Schwerer Panzerbüchse is the weapon, it's a heavy anti-tank rifle. And Sonderkraftfahrzeug means special motorized vehicle, which is the base designation that the Germans gave to basically all of their land vehicles. Of course, we have some of the Panzer II and Panzer III variants. The Panzerkampfwagen 3 Ausführung B, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 141. The Panzer II being the Panzerkampfwagen 2 Ausführung F, aus Sonderkraftfahrzeug 121. Panzerkampfwagen, in case you don't know, is three words. The Germans like to take multiple words to make one word to describe the thing perfectly. Panzerkampfwagen being the combination of Panzer, meaning armor, Kampf, meaning combat, and Wagen, meaning vehicle. It's an armored combat vehicle. Incredible. Anti-air vehicles tend to be a bit more complicated. This one is the Gepanzerter Munitionsschlepper Sonderkraftfahrzeug 111 auf Fahrgestell Panzerkampfwagen 1 Ausführung A mit 2 cm Flugabwehrkanone 38 Selbstfahr Flugabwehrbataillon 614. Gepanzerter Munitionsschlepper means armored munitions carrier. Fahrgestell is the chassis. In this case, it is based on the Panzer 1A. It has a 2 cm Flugabwehrkanone. Flak means anti-air cannon. The SF stands for Selbstfahr. In some of the later variants, we're also going to see Selbstfahrlafette. This essentially designates the mounts. And Flugabwehrbataillon 614 is the unit that this vehicle was used in real life. Anti-air battalion 614. We have the venerable Panzerkampfwagen 35T. As one of the old van vehicles, we have the Mittlerer Schützenpanzerwagen Ausführung D mit 3,7 Panzerabwehrkanone Sonderkraftfahrzeug 251-10. I have to admit here, I have no idea what SIG actually stands for, so if you know, do let me know in the comments. In any case, this is the 15 cm SIG 33 Selbstfahrlafette auf Panzerkampfwagen 2 Ausführung B. Our first Panzer 4, the Panzerkampfwagen 4 Ausführung C, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 161. Flak Panzer 38 auf Selbstfahrlafette 38 Ausführung L, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 140. Here we have the first mention of Selbstfahrlafette. As I mentioned before, it's basically a self-propelled gun. Just in this case, not the classical SPG designation that you may be used to from the Allied side with big guns. This is an anti-aircraft cannon. Schwerer Panzerspielwagen 2 cm, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 234-1. 4,7 cm Panzerabwehrkanone 36 Tschechien, Selbstfahrlafette auf Fahrgestell Panzerkampfwagen 1, zweite Serie. You don't choose the Sturmgeschütz live. The Sturmgeschütz live chooses you. This is the Sturmgeschütz 3 Ausführung A, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 142. Here we have a Aufklärungspanzer 38, 2 cm, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 41-1, Aufklärungspanzer meaning a scout vehicle. Here we have a schwerer Panzerspielwagen 7,5 cm, kurz, glaube ich, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 234-3. Ah, der Neubau Panzerkampfwagen 4 mit 3,7 und 7,5 cm Kanonen. Ja, moving on to Rank 2, we have the Puma, the first one. Schwerer Panzerspielwagen, 5 cm, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 234-2, Puma. Das ist die 3,7 cm Flugabwehrkanone 36 auf Fahrgestell, Zugkraftwagen 5 Tonnen, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 6-2. Flag, as you know, stands for Flugabwehrkanone, Anti-Air Cannon, Fahrgestell is the chassis. Zugkraftwagen means essentially, it's a lorry, it's a truck. It's a heavy-duty transport vehicle, and this one has the capability of carrying 5 tons. It's not the mass of the vehicle itself. As you can see, the mass is actually quite a bit higher. The vehicle itself can carry 5 tons of extra load, however. And one of my favorites, die Sturmhaubitze, Ausführung G, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 142-2. Haubitze is very similar to the English word howitzer, because that is exactly what it means. The Venerable Marder, also known as the Panzerjäger 38 Tschechien, für 7,5 cm Panzerabwehrkanone 40-2, Ausführung H, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 138. I'm not sure if I mentioned before, by the way, Ausführung means Variant. This is the mittlerer Schützenpanzerwagen Ausführung D mit 1,5 cm Drilling, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 251-21. This is the Panzer-Selbstfahrlafette 1C. Das ist die 10,5 cm Kanone 18 auf Panzer-Selbstfahrlafette 4A, also known as the Dicker Max. 15 cm Panzerwerfer 42 auf Selbstfahrlafette Gleisketten Lastkraftwagen, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 4-1. There's a lot to unpack here. So, Panzerwerfer literally translated means tank launcher. This is a rocket system. This is my Panzerwerfer. It werfs Panzers. Gleisketten Lastkraftwagen. Gleisketten means tracks that you usually find in tanks. This is a half-track vehicle. Lastkraftwagen meaning truck. So this is a tracked truck. It's a half-track. Half-truck. Mittlerer Schützenpanzerwagen Ausführung D mit 7,5 cm Panzerabwehrkanone Sonderkraftfahrzeug 251-22. Die Panzerkampfwagen 747 Russland Ausführung D looks remarkably like a captured T-34. I wonder what the R stands for. Ooh, now we're getting into the spicy stuff. Rank 3. 8,8 cm Flugabwehrkanone 37 Selbstfahrlafette auf schwerem Zugkraftwagen 18 Tonnen. Panzerkampfwagen Tiger, Ausführung E früh. Sonderkraftfahrzeug 181. Of course, with the later variant being the Panzerkampfwagen Tiger, Ausführung E spät. Sonderkraftfahrzeug 181. This means early, this means late. Stuck in the field due to transmission problems is the Panzerkampfwagen Panther, Ausführung D, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 171. Defending the skies is the Flak Panzerkampfwagen 4, 2 cm Flugabwehrkanone 38 Vierling, Sonderkraftfahrzeug und 161-4. I failed to mention earlier in this one, Drilling means triple, Vierling means quad, Zwilling means double. It's twins, triplets, quadruplets. It defines the number of guns. Die Jagdpanzer 38, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 138-2, also known as the Hetzer. Adorable little thing. Das schwerer Panzerkampfwagen 754 Russland looks remarkably like a KV-2. I wonder what the R stands for. Schwerer Panzerspielwagen, 7,5 cm Panzeralpha-Kanone, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 234-4, Panzeralpha-Kanonenwagen. Panzer-Selbstfahrlafette für 12,8 cm Kanone 40, also known as die Stura Emil. Das ist die Flak-Panzerkampfwagen 4, 3,7 cm Flugabwehrkanone 43, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 161-4. Here we have die Jagdpanzer 4, Ausführung F, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 162. Jagdpanzer meaning hunting tank, it's a tank destroyer. Panzerbefehlswagen 4, Ausführung J. Befehlswagen is essentially the command vehicle. These were specialized versions of tanks equipped with better radio equipment, designated for the commanders of the tank groups. Can I just skip this one? It barely fits in a text box. No? Fine. 8,8 cm Panzerabwehrkanone 43-1L-71 auf Geschützwagen 3-4. Selbstfahrlafette Nashorn, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 164.
Are you happy now?
Das Infanterie-Panzerkampfwagen 57 England Lux. Okay, it's getting old, I'm sorry. Infanterie-Panzerkampfwagen, of course, meaning Infantry Tank. It's a infantry support vehicle, as the English designed it. This is not German, and I will not attempt to speak this out. Hans, bring sie Sturmgeschütz 4 für 15 cm Sturmhaubitze 43. Ausführung 2, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 166. Bring sie Brummbär. This is the 8,8 cm Flugabwehrkanone 41 auf Panzer-Selbstfahrlafette 4C, also known as the Versuchsflugabwehrkanonenwagen. Das Panzerkampfwagen Panther Ausführung G als Ersatz M10, Panzerbrigade 150. Looks remarkably like an M10 Wolverine. Wait. Why is there an A? Oh, hold on a second. This is the schwerer Panzerkampfwagen 756 Russland, Ausführung C, mit 7,5 cm Kampfwagenkanone 40. Oh, I should mention, by the way, the difference between KWK and PAK, as you can see on this one, KWK stands for Kampfwagenkanone, PAK stands for Panzerabwehrkanone. Essentially, Kampfwagenkanone is just a combat cannon. It's a general-purpose combat cannon. Panzerabwehrkanone is more designated for anti-tank duties. Again, I must admit, I'm not entirely sure what the VK actually stands for. I know it's Versuchs-something. Versuchskarre? Let me know in the comments. Anyway, this is the Porsche Typ 101 VK45.01P. Zweimal Porsche. Doppelter Porsche. On to Rank 4 with the Late War Vehicles. We have the 8,8 cm Waffenträger Krupp Steyr. Krupp Steyr being the manufacturers of the vehicle. Waffenträger meaning just gun carrier. This is the Panzerkampfwagen Tiger Ausführung B mit frühem Turm. Fahrgestell Nummer 1 bis 50, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 182. Fahrgestell Nummer 1 bis 50 just means that the first 50 tanks of the series were fitted with this early Turm, dem frühen Turm. Whereas later, the production variant and the most famous variant, of course, of the Tiger 2 was the Panzerkampfwagen Tiger Ausführung B mit Serienturm. Serienturm meaning the serial turret. Flugabwehrkanone Panzerkampfwagen 4 mit 3,7 cm Flugabwehrkanone Zwilling. Zwilling? What does it mean? Yes, Twin. This is the Panzerjäger Panther, 8,8 cm Ausführung G1, Sonderkraftfahrzeug 173. Panzerjäger, of course, meaning the anti-tank variants, the tank destroyers. There is another Panzerbefehlswagen, Tiger 1P, this, of course, being another command vehicle. This is a post-war tank, the first of many we will see. This is the Leichter Kampfpanzer M51G. Here we also have a Hanomag Henschel Kanonenjagdpanzer, 4-5. Here we have a command tank destroyer, a Panzerjägerbefehlswagen Panther, 8,8 cm Ausführung G1. Panzerjäger Tiger Porsche Ferdinand Sonderkraftfahrzeug 184. And of course the Panzerjäger Tiger P Elefant Sonderkraftfahrzeug 184. Die 3,7 cm Flugabwehrkanonen Zwilling auf Panzerfahrgestell Flakpanzergerät 554. Also nun ist die Kölian oder Quelian. Die Panzerkampfwagen Panther 2 mit 8,8 cm Kampfwagenkanone L71. At Rank 5 we do get into some of the more proper post-war stuff. Starting off with the Schützenpanzer Marder 1A1. Schützenpanzer is basically roughly translatable over to infantry fighting vehicle. Another designation for this in German would be Infanteriekampfpanzer. Mittlerer Kampfpanzer M48A2C, der Kampfpanzer Leopard 1. Can I just mention, by the way, how much simplified the names are in post-war German vehicles compared to the randoms of the Second World War with the just casual, leichter Flakpanzer 4 mit 3 cm Motorkanone 103 als Zwillingwaffe. It's easy. Die Panzerjäger-Tiger Ausführung BH auf Sonderkraftfahrzeug 186, this of course being die Jagdtiger. A special one here as well, die Panzerkampfwagen-Tiger Ausführung B mit 10,5 cm Kampfwagenkanone L-68. Here we have an East German Schützenpanzer BMP 1P SB4. Here we have another gun carrier, die Waffenträger Wiesel 1A4 MK20. Which in this case I'm going to assume is a Maschinenkanone and not a Motorkanone, like it is on the Kugelblitz. This is very German. Die Erprobungsträger mit dreiachsig stabilisiertem Turm, 3F. Erprobungsträger is experimental carrier with a three-axis stabilized turret. There's quite an interesting history behind this one. I would recommend you look up some videos by other content creators or look up some history on the internet yourself. My beloved. Die Entwicklungsfahrzeug 100 Tigermaus mit Mausturm und Projekt B Antrieb. Die E100. Entwicklungsfahrzeug meaning development vehicle. Mit Mausturm, meaning that it has the turret of the Maus. Of course, we can't forget our Panzerkampfwagen Maus, Versuchsfahrgestell Nummer 2. So, this isn't German, but I do speak Portuguese, so I'll try and pronounce it that way. Carro de Combate, Tanque Argentino Mediano. Kampfpanzer Leopard 1A1A1A1A1A1A. Flugabwehrkanonenpanzer Gepard 1 Typ B2. Raketenjagdpanzer 2 HOT. Versuchsträger 1-2. Schützenpanzer Puma. Kampfpanzer Leopard 2K Prototyp 6 mit Turm 5. As far as I'm aware. Waffenträger Wiesel 2. Leichtes Flugabwehrsystem Ocelot. Kampfpanzer Leopard 1 A1 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 mit Rheinmetall 120 44 Kanone. Begleitpanzer 57. Begleit means accompany, support. It's essentially a convoy support vehicle. Kampfpanzer Leopard 2 A4C von der Panzerbataillon 123.
Which, by the way, if you want to buy this vehicle, you can use the link in the description and get 3% off as well as my decal for free. Yes, I am shilling.
Experimentalfahrzeug Rat 8x8, Kampfpanzer Leopard 2 Prototyp 16 mit Turm 14. And finishing off with Rank 7 with the beautifully simple Flugabwehrraketenpanzer 1 auf dem Flugabwehrraketenpanzer 1 auf Marderfahrgestell mit Flugabwehrraketensystem Roland.
But wait, there's more.
Flugabwehrraketenradwagen 1 A2 auf Mann LKW Flugabwehrraketenwagen 1 A2 auf MAN Lastkraftwagen 15T 15 Tonnen Militär GL1 BR 8x8 mit Flugabwehrraketensystem Roland. Okay, I think that's going to be enough German for one day. That has been basically every single unique German vehicle so far in the entire game. I will be on vacation for the next 2 weeks, so don't expect any videos from me then. But if you enjoyed this one, then I do recommend checking out the previous one I made 5 years ago and see if, well, you can see how much the game has changed since then. If you like this mod, you can download it in the link in the description down below. This is the mod by Infernos, of course, which you can install to get all these complicated names in your own game. Also down there, you can find my affiliate link to the Gaijin store. If you click on it and buy anything on the store, you get my free decal. And you can also get a 3% discount on anything that is not already discounted. Doesn't matter if it's a 150G pack or a one of the big bundles. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like. I will not make any promises about Russian pronunciation videos this time. Maybe sometime in 10 years, we'll see. My name is Mikus Boom. I have sort of enjoyed making this video, and I'll see you around in the next one. Goodbye.